Hello, fellow Pipers. You are now currently watching a live episode of Cops. No, not really. Actually, a white couple got pulled over. The dude handcuffed. Their car searched. Probably consented to it. Didn't see a dog out there. Why can't they just leave poor white folk alone? Anyways, that's not why I'm making this video. So if you saw my clusterfuck of a review last night, I did Five Brothers. Which is a company I can't figure out how they are still in business. So what am I currently smoking? Well, first of all, smoking in this Turkish meerschaum. Oh my god, it was brand new. Never smoked. And ever since I got it, I've only smoked English blends in it. Which means I'm smoking an English blend. John Bull. Royal English Pipe Tobacco. I have to get this right. A proper English blend combined bright Virginias and Burleys with a hint of black Cavendish and smoked Latakia. Isn't that how you could describe the recent royal wedding? Anyways. This is my first bowl. Say it is quite delightful. Now when I smell it in the bag, it does have that campfire smell to it. Definitely a lot of Kia comes out, but when you're smoking it, that smokiness like subsides, which is kind of cool. No tongue bite at all. And a little bit of sweetness in the side. And I bought this from Pipes and Cigars. Yeah. So I have to say, this is a really nice English blend. I mean, the way that they made this, it's not too dry, it's not too wet, it's like pressed in the pack. You have to break it apart in order to pack it into the pipe. So it's basically perfect to go once you get it. It is delightful. I mean, if you're looking for like an everyday smoke and you dug English blend, this might be it. So, I guess in this video, I'm not gonna be gagging or puking or coughing. The mosquitoes have somewhat subsided, but I am wearing a hat, insulated flannel. It's only like 70 degrees outside, but that's how much I hate getting bit by mosquitoes. So on a side note, today is Saturday, June 2nd. The biggest Saturday of the year for my city. And I tried to drop some stuff off this morning at an antique booth that the girlfriend and I both run. Seriously, all I wanted to do was a 5 minute, here's the stuff, put it on the shelf, just walk out, drive home. Not one freaking parking spot in all of downtown. And the little meter maids were driving around, their three-wheel little go-kart things, ticketing people left and right. And they wonder why nobody wants to come downtown. But there are so many people down there. After that, I had like zero interest of going down there, which has been kind of like my own personal tradition for, say, the last decade. Go down, see the art fair, have a few beers, just kind of hang out and chill. But it was a madhouse, and I was so frustrated and pissed off that, I'm not just some tourist. I live here. I have a small business downtown. I'm just trying to conduct some business, actually, make some things accessible for whoever might stop into the shop. Nope. Not one freaking parking spot. And I'm talking anywhere. So I get home, and Sarah says, I really just want to get out of town. And I was like, yeah, me too. So we ended up just jumping on one of the old state highways. And just drove to Lake Michigan. Stopped at a bunch of antique shops along the way. Didn't really buy anything. Ran into a few wineries that I haven't been to in a few years. Found a couple new ones that I didn't even know about. Tried some wine, went to the beach. Had some really great pizza in St. Joe's. And after that, we're like, okay, let's just go home. And that was how we spent the day. So, got the hell out of Dodge. Had a lot more fun. And the whole time this morning, I'm thinking, we need a plague. We really just need a plague. Who are all these useless fucks? And who comes to an art fair? Seriously, for the last 15 years, it's been the same booths, the same pieces of art, same pottery, same jewelry, all the same shit, year after year. And it's always horrible food, horrible, God, corn dogs, elephant ears, cotton candy. There's no rides. It's an art fair. Okay? Like, where the hell's like the artisanal foods? Where's the good stuff? Where are you getting creative? Where's the fusion? Oh, yeah, there was Gorilla Gourmet, and for, God, what was it? It's like $7 or $8. You get like three dinky little tacos, and the so-called meat on the taco is fucking sauerkraut. If the Russians were starving on it, how are you charging so much for it? So anyways, no art fair this year. Didn't get to go to my antique shop. Visited a few others, didn't buy anything. So that was my Saturday. Didn't even see any pipes. It was weird. All the typewriters I saw were over $100 and they're all junk, had missing parts. Well, not all were junk. I did see a really cool Krona portable folding typewriter. I never realized how tiny those things actually were until I saw one today. But it was $125. And considering the condition, it was actually a fair price for it. Just not what I was willing to pay. So, yeah, just bought a couple bottles of wine and came home. And you know what? It wasn't a bad day. Now I'm just chilling on the porch, enjoying a nice smoke, not being disappointed. Oh, did I mention the English tobacco boycott was over? It was only that weekend. And considering the description on this one, I think it's an appropriate start. So, anyways, I'll leave it at that. Until next time, y'all take care of yourselves.